She was glamorous and turned into incredible beauty.
When we are dancing and you're dangerously near me.
She did everything very well. She danced very well. And she's quite naughty.
In a sense, it's a fairy tale. You have a young, very beautiful, very popular princess.
I want to hold you so much closer than I dare to.
In love with a Battle of Britain pilot.
She needed a hero. And, of course, Townsend was a hero. She was wildly in love with this young man, wanted to marry him, but it just wasn't possible.
He had this one fatal flaw, which was that he had been through a divorce.
50 years ago, the Queen's sister, Princess Margaret, faced a dilemma. Either marry her lover, Peter Townsend, and lose her royal privileges, or renounce him and put duty first.
May the great question be answered soon, one way or the other.
It was the first modern royal scandal, and its conclusion had the nation gripped.
I would like it to be known that I have decided not to marry Group Captain Peter Townsend, and conscious of my duty to the Commonwealth, I have resolved...
For 50 years, it's been generally believed that Margaret was forced to make a terrible choice. But now, secret and personal documents have been released that pose the question. Was Margaret's a needless sacrifice?
Duchess of York, Princesses Elizabeth and Margaret Rose.
Even as young children, Princess Margaret Rose and her older sister Elizabeth found themselves in the forefront of public attention.
And Princess Margaret Rose enjoys every moment of it.
With the abdication crisis looming, the close family of the little princesses, aged 6 and 10, contrasted favorably with the sensational private life of their uncle, the King.
What one has to bear in mind is that Edward VIII wasn't married. And what the public really liked, then as now, in a way, was family life. They liked royal family life.
The princess was very popular, I mean, because as a little girl, there she was, the smaller sister with her older sister, often the two of them dressed alike. And it was clear, was this a tremendously happy family unit. I mean, that was what was projected, but that's also what was the truth.
To me, she was always this immensely glamorous little girl, always the very outgoing one, bubbly. I believe she was her father's favorite. She was just so outgoing.
Her father, he adored both the daughters. He had a very sort of subtle, rather charming relationship with his younger daughter. And in a sense, she was allowed to be a little bit spoilt and mischievous and get away with things.
It was often said that he looked at this vivacious, artistic, fun-loving creature and was absolutely amazed that he'd produced her.
But the carefree life of little Princess Margaret and her family was about to change forever.
December the 10th, 1936, one of the most momentous days in the history of England.
Margaret's uncle, Edward VIII, became the first British monarch to willingly give up his throne when he chose to marry divorcee Wallis Simpson.
A few hours ago, I discharged my last duty as King and Emperor.
For Margaret, it meant her father's unprepared for and unwelcome succession.
suddenly they were catapulted onto the world stage, really. I remember her saying to me, and you know, one moment we were sort of close-knit sort of family, having a really sort of fairly ordinary life, and suddenly there we were at Buckingham Palace, and I think it had a huge effect on her.
She would have been genuinely worried about her father's health, which hadn't been good for a long time, and she must have realized what a terrible strain that would put on him.
While in Canada, they traveled from coast to coast and met literally thousands of Canadians personally.
Her father became the most reluctant king. It was something that caused him a nervous breakdown.
Their Majesties became ambassadors of goodwill to the United States, where they
the were abdication to both those little girls must have been absolutely shattering.
Gladly and willingly did the king put the cares of state.
So I think she must have felt very angry at Uncle David.
Giving up his throne on the eve of World War II to become the third husband of an American commoner, Margaret's family frowned upon her uncle's behavior.
Can't have had much love for him. I think he failed in his duty, and they were very duty conscious.
She just felt, I think, that her uncle had packed it in. She had never talked about him much, and when she did, she wasn't very complimentary.
We feel you will welcome these intimate pictures of our beloved King and Queen, with their children, the Princess Elizabeth, heir to the throne, and her sister, Princess Margaret Rose.
Princess Margaret was now daughter to a king, but she was not his heir. That role fell to Elizabeth.
It must have changed her relationship with the Queen, because whereas they'd always done things together, now the Queen had a very important role to play and obviously had to be coached in all the things that a future monarch would have to know. And I suppose there might even have been some feelings of jealousy.
I think if she had any resentment about her childhood, and I think she did have a certain amount of resentment, it was more, I think, when looking back, that she felt that she hadn't been given a good enough education. And I think there is some justification in that.
Life in these character-forming years was a life.
Both princesses were taught at home. But unlike her older sister, Margaret never received any further education.
She was a very clever Princess Margaret. And I think if she hadn't been the Queen's younger sister, she would have gone to university. But in those days, you know, that was out of the question.
With Elizabeth cast as the serious-minded heir apparent, Margaret would play a different role.
I think this is one of the tragedies of her life, that she never knew who she was, never knew who she was supposed to be, and she left it to others, not least the media, to work it out for her.
Lilibet knows more about knitting, but it's jolly interesting all the same.
She was rather sidelined, and that's why she became this outgoing, extravagant person, because she felt she had to make her mark in some way.
The princesses were just 9 and 13 years old when the Second World War broke out.
Princess Margaret Rose and her friends accept the intrusion into their camp routine with good humor.
The Queen said, if the King remains in England, I remain in England, and my daughters remain in England. And it was wonderful, as children, to know that the princesses are here, you know, at Windsor.
The King's absence in Italy saw Princess Elizabeth helping with the washing up.
The images of the King and Queen, or particularly the Queen and perhaps in a little pony cart with the King and the two daughters bicycling behind her, were very, very wonderful images, particularly when you compare them to what was going on in Nazi Germany at the time. There was a huge admiration for the whole family at that time, and deep love for them as well.
Probably gave people a lift and gave them extra courage, because they were brave, and I think they stood out like beacons. They really did.